Hello everyone, see this is about SRTF, shortest remaining time first question, which is asked in gate 2007. They are saying to find the waiting time of process P2. See, they have given this, they have given four process and they have given the arrival time and bus time. Now they are saying to find the waiting time of the process P2. So see, we will start now. See, first of all we have to draw the Gantt chart. This is called Gantt chart. See, it is about shortest remaining time first. So first is coming P1, arrival time is 0. So we are starting from 0, 0, P1 comes, and how much it will run? It will run for next 15 units, because the next arrival time of process P2 is 15. So it will run for 15 units. And how much will be left here? Here it will be left, only 5 units will be left. 5 units will be left. Now see, P2 is arrived. Now see, which is the shortest remaining process, shortest remaining bus time? See, P1 is having shortest remaining bus time, that is with 5 units. So now P1 will come, because P2 is having highest bus time than P1. So P1 will come, because it is our shortest remaining. So P1 will run for how many units? It will run for again, see, it will run for again 5 units, so it will become 20 and it will become 0. It will become 0. See, now see, only P2 is available, because P3's arrival time is 30 and we have only 20. So now P2 will come and it will run for how many units? See, up to 30 units it will run, because 30 is the next arrival time of process P3. So P2 will come, it will run for more 10 units, it will become 30. How much is remaining here? 15 is remaining, because 25 minus 10, 15. See, now see, P3 is also arrived here and P2 is also available. See, which is the shortest remaining? See, P3 is having shortest remaining time first, because it is 10. So P3 will run up to how many units? 45 units, means 15. But we have only 10 units, so P3 will come and run for again more 10 units. So it will become 40 and it will become 0. So see, now P4 is not available, because it arrival time is 45 now, but it is having only 40. So P2 will come and it will run for more 5 units. It will become 10 and it will run for more 5 units. Now see, now P2 is having for 10 and P4 is having 15. Now which is the shortest one? P2 is having the shortest one. See, you are understanding, no? See, P2 is having 10 units and P4 is remaining 15 units. Now which one is the shortest? P2 is having the shortest. So P2 will come again and run for, means full unit, that is 55. It will become 0. And now the remaining P4, it will come. P4, it will run for the remaining 15 units, that is 55 plus 15, that is 70. So now we have to write the completion time. See, completion time of P4 is 70. And P3 is 40, and P2 is 55, and P1 is 20. See, you know what is completion time? See, completion time is this one, then this one. This is the completion time of the process. See, now to find the turnaround time. So what's the formula of turnaround time? Completion time minus arrival time. Completion time minus arrival. So completion time here for P1 is 20, 20 minus 0 is 20. Similarly, 55 minus 15, it is 40. Then 40 minus 30, then it is 10. 70 minus 35, it is 25. See, now what is the waiting time formula? Waiting time formula is turnaround time minus bus time. Turnaround time minus, see, this minus this. See, what is the actual bus time here? 20, 25, 10 and 15. Not this, because I have made it to understand you what are the time remaining after execution of each processes. See, waiting time of a P1 will be, see, turnaround time minus bus time. 20 minus 20, it will be 0. Then waiting time of P2 will be 40 minus 25. It will be how much? It will be, I think, is 15. So this is the final answer. You can find it more also. But there is saying to find the waiting time of the process P2 only. So I find out 15. So they have given four options. One is 15 milliseconds is the right answer. So thanks for watching. Please subscribe my channel for more upcoming videos. Thank you.